Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome at this press point following the meeting that Commissioner for European Neighbourhood Policy and Enlargement Negotiations, Johannes Hahn, just had with Deputy Prime Minister of Kosovo, Hashim Thaçi. They will both make short introductory statements, and then we will take a couple of questions. Commissioner Hahn, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, and excuse my voice, so I try to be rather brief. I have to say I'm really very pleased to have met today Deputy Prime Minister Hashim Thaçi and the new Minister for European Integration, Pekin Kulaku, and I really appreciate that they have traveled to Brussels not even a week after their nomination, and our meeting, I think, confirms that we both consider progress on its European path to be of crucial importance to Kosovo, to the region, and also to the European Union itself. We had a very fruitful discussion, and I congratulated the Minister for the recent establishment of the new government in Pristina and their appointment. And once again, I reassured both of the continued commitment of the Union to Kosovo's European perspective. We discussed markers for progress in the EU-Kosovo relations for next year. I look forward to our Member States' agreement to sign and conclude the stabilization and association agreement we negotiated with Kosovo last year, and I hope to be able to put forward proposals to this effect in March and have the adoption process completed by the end of 2015. We also discussed Kosovo's efforts to secure visa-free travel. The second progress report on visa liberalization issued last summer confirmed important progress, but it also included important recommendation, and like always, it's about concrete and sustainable implementation of things. The nomination of a new government in Pristina last week marked the end of a period of almost 6 months of political stalemate. It's time for Kosovo to resume work on its European reform agenda, and it's expressed by the fact that the two ministers have traveled to Brussels, as I said, immediately after their appointment. The rule of law continues to be priority, and Kosovo, of course, has to demonstrate its clear commitment to deliver results in the fight against organized crime and corruption. However, the need for renewed commitment to reform goes beyond the rule of law. Next year, Kosovo needs to deliver on its wider reform agenda in key areas, including electoral, economic, and public administration reform. I also urge the new Kosovo government to resume the EU-facilitated dialogue with Serbia, and I've understood there are already first discussions between the two. The April agreement and what has been decided at technical level needs to be implemented. I look forward to the full implementation of all the agreements, including for cadastre and university diplomas. Let me conclude by noting that the European Union continues to attach great importance to Kosovo's progress and the realization of its European perspective, and I very much look forward to working with the new Kosovo government, and I have been invited to visit Kosovo, and I will be certainly there in the first quarter of next year.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Deputy Prime Minister, you have the floor.
In the ruari, Commissioner Hahn, the only që fillimisht ju falenderoj për pritjen e sotme në Bruxelles. Ky është takimi I parë bilateral mes komisionerit dhe përfaqësuesve të qeverisë së Kosovës, qeverisë së re, që doli nga zgjedhjet e fundit të qershorit, kështu që tash Kosova ka institucione të reja, ka institucione stabile dhe me besim të madh edhe efektive.
Dear Commissioner Hahn, thank you very much for having us here today in Brussels. This is the first bilateral meeting between the Commissioner and the representatives of Kosovo government, and since the last elections that we had in Kosovo, and now, as of that time, we've had stable institutions that were created.
Ne zhvillohemi takim të shkëlqyeshëm, i urova komisionerin Han për emrimin e tij dhe shpreha gatishmërinë për të bashkëpunuar në drejtim të avancimit të agjendës së integrimit evropian për shtetin e Kosovës.
This was an excellent starting introductory meeting, and where I've congratulated Commissioner Han for his appointment, and I expressed our readiness to cooperate in to work together to advance the Kosovo's European integration agenda.
Informova komisionerin për zhvillimet e fundit politike në Kosovë dhe reafirmova angazhimin e qeverisë së Kosovës për të punuar në procesin e integrimeve evropiane.
I informed the commissioner about the last political developments in Kosovo, and I also reaffirmed the commitment of the new government for deep and far-reaching reforms in order to fulfill Kosovo's European integration.
Ka ndërtuar një qeveri stabile me bazë të gjerë politike dhe përfshirje gjithë etnike, duke nënkuptuar edhe serbët nga veriu që janë pjesë edhe qeverisë Kosovës edhe parlamentit.
Kosovo has formed a new stable government, which is an inclusive one, includes also the different communities, and especially the Kosovo Serbs in the north, and we intend to work together.
Rikonfirmohet njërë sot zotimin para komisionerit se qeveria Kosovës, institucionet e Kosovës janë të zotuar ata implementojnë në tërsi marrëveshjen e Bruxellit.
I also expressed the firm commitment of the Kosovo government to fully implement the Brussels agreement.
Përfundimi i negociatave për marrëveshjen e stabilizimit dhe asociimit këtë vit është një rëndësi të madhe për fillimin e vitit të ardhshëm.
The completion of the negotiations for stabilization association agreement was an important thing and something that's going to be very important for the next phase in next year.
Ne tani shikojmë hapin tjetër atë në shkrimet e marrëveshjes.
We are looking towards now the signing of the agreement.
Dhe hyrje në fuqi të mesas.
And its entry into force.
Mendoj se konkluzionet e këshillit për çështjet e jashtme këtë javë kanë bërthirë komisionit për proces propozimeve të shteteve anëtare për në shkrimin e kësaj marrëveshje të parë kontraktuale mes Kosovës dhe BE-s. Kjo ishte një mbështetje jashtëzakonisht e rëndësishme e tërë procesit.
I think that the conclusions of the General Affairs Council this week to this end, calling on the Commission to present the proposals for the signing of the SAA, was a very good support towards the process.
Gjithashtu, procesi i liberalizimit e vizave do jetë një prej prioriteteve kryesore për Kosovën.
Also, the visa liberalization process will be a key priority for the government of
Kosovo.
And we will fulfill all the requirements of the process.
Kosova do të tregoj përgjegjësi të lartë në procesin e vazhdimit të dialogut me Serbinë.
Kosovo will also continue to be highly engaged in the dialogue with Serbia.
Që shpresoj që do të vazhdojnë në pjesën e dytë të janarit.
Which is to start in the second part of January next year.
Për arritjen e marrëveshjeve të reja dhe implementimin e tërësi të gjitha marrëveshjeve të arritura deri më tani.
With the aim of having new agreements and completing the agreements that we had thus far.
Falenderoj ndër komisionerin për pritjet e tij sot në Bruxelles dhe ju uroj mirëseardhje në Prishtinë.
I want to thank once again the commissioner for having us here in Brussels, and we look forward to your visit in Pristina next year as well.
He says, I have already understood.
I take a couple of questions, so I see quite a few of them, but Augustine and Enrico.
Thank you. Augustine Palokai from Coaditore. Commissioner Han, the SAA agreement is now under the check from the experts in the Commission, and all the things that have to happen are procedural. So. It will enter into force eventually. But what can be the next step in Kosovo's EU integration? Because this agreement doesn't commit the European Union politically at the same level as the SAAs with other countries in the region. What would EU do if Kosovo, for example, decides to do a next step to apply for membership in the European Union? And the second question is about the visa liberalization. I know this is maybe not your portfolio directly, but still, since you are engaged with the relations with Kosovo, there is a growing number of asylum seekers from Kosovo in several EU member states. Will this endanger the visa liberalization process, and what can you say to the new promises from Kosovo government representatives, including new prime minister, that early next year the visa liberalization might happen? Thank you.
Yeah, concerning the first, the whole move towards the European Union, and it's clear, they have said it, there is a European perspective for Kosovo, but this can only be done step by step, and that's why we are talking about the process and less about negotiations. Therefore, it's important that Kosovo, together with Serbia, they also have good reasons for doing that, are again starting and continuing this negotiating their joint topics. But this is something. The other area is to make progress on some internal issues, as I have said, in the area of rule of law. That's why we are so interested for different reasons that, for instance, the Palace of Justice will be completed in order to allow to move in all the different players in the judiciary system to be in one house and to contribute to a further improvement of the judiciary system in Kosovo. So it's about a process, and one has to be realistic but ambitious and at the same way pragmatic. Concerning visa, there are certain procedures foreseen in our way to make the necessary assessments, and this is more or less independent from outside influences, but it's also about the sustainable implementation of certain measures which have to be demonstrated and proven, and that's why we have at least two phases which include the report about that also to our member states, and based on that decisions can be taken. We should also hear ambitious but realistic what concerns the time frame.
We'll take Rickard. I'm really sorry, but in the interest of time, we can only take a couple. Thank you.
It work? Yeah, no, it works slow.
Is it necessary? Hello. Yeah, now it's nice. If you look into the agreement, there are areas which can be implemented by each side by its own. And this is, by the way, the majority of the agreements. And this is why I have urged the Serbians, but also the Kosovari today, to do what is in their, so to say, own responsibility. Where it is not necessary to wait on governments. For instance, the issue of the national dial code is such an issue where I believe this is something which can be done apparently by the Serbian government by itself.
Okay, unfortunately, we really, in the interest of time, have to stop at this point. I thank you very much for coming and see you at the next occasion.